Good morning. I'm Andy Rich. I'm Dean of the Colin Powell School for Civic and Global Leadership, and I want to welcome you to this very special celebration of the class of 2020. This is an extraordinary day in really the truest sense of the word. It's extraordinary because we get to celebrate the achievements of more than 900 new graduates of the Colin Powell School, and it is extraordinary because we should be doing it together. We should be on the South Lawn of campus. We should be cheering, all of us, family, friends, professors, staff, everybody, as our graduates cross the stage and shake hands and get hugs. We can't do that today, but we can absolutely celebrate the achievements of the new graduates of the class of 2020. So congratulations, class. We are so proud of you, and we are so sure that you are ready to face the challenges and opportunities that the world has in store for you. As we start this morning, I want to provide a special thanks to those who make it possible for all of you to achieve your dreams, and that is the family and the friends of our new graduates. I hope most of you are with some family or with some friends, or at least in touch with them over Zoom, that they're joining us here this morning, and I want to thank all of them for the level of support that they have provided for each and every one of you so that you can achieve your dreams of finishing your degrees and everything that's going to come after. For some of you, this was a quick 2 years, 4 years. For some of you, it's taken a little bit longer. For some of you, there's been a whole lot of twists and turns, and for some of you, it's been a straight trajectory. But everybody, each and every one of you has done it, you're finished, congratulations. As I was thinking about what words would capture this special moment, the extraordinary qualities of this special moment, I was reminded of the eloquence of our graduation speaker back in 2016 at City College. On June 3rd, 2016, 4 years ago, just at the time that some of you were about to start your journey at City College, the commencement speaker was Michelle Obama. It was her last commencement speech as First Lady. And let's listen to just a little bit of what she had to say that day.
And graduates, you all have faced challenges far greater than anything I or my family have ever experienced. Challenges that most college students could never even imagine. Some of you have been homeless. Some of you have risked the rejection of your families to pursue your education. Many of you have lain awake at night wondering how on earth you were going to support your parents and your kids and still pay tuition. And many of you know what it's like to live not just month to month or day to day, but meal to meal. But graduates, let me tell you, you should never ever be embarrassed by those struggles. You should never view your challenges as a disadvantage. Instead, it's important for you to understand that your experience facing and overcoming adversity is actually one of your biggest advantages. But graduates, as you all know, life will put many obstacles in your path that are far worse than a bad grade. You'll have unreasonable bosses and difficult clients and patients. You'll experience illnesses and losses, crises and setbacks that will come out of nowhere and knock you off your feet. But unlike so many other young people, you have already developed the resilience and the maturity that you need to pick yourself up and dust yourself off and keep moving through the pain. Keep moving forward. You have developed that muscle. And with the education you've gotten at this fine school and the experiences you've had in your lives, let me tell you, nothing, and I mean nothing, is going to stop you from fulfilling your dreams. And you deserve every last one of the successes that I know you will have.
Mrs. Obama's remarks from 4 years ago, I think, still ring very true today. It's hard, though, right now to think about the future. I think in the midst of this pandemic, we're very much focused on the present and the present as it kind of recreates itself each day. But I do want to invite each and every one of you to take a moment today and as we move forward to really focus on your future. We believe at the Colin Powell School, the faculty, the staff, all of us, that you're ready. You are ready to go out into the world and be leaders in this city, to be leaders in this nation, and to make a positive difference on some of the profound challenges that we face as a society. You've shown a determination, you have shown a resilience, and you have shown a talent that has prepared you for the big challenges and the big opportunities. And we could not be more excited to see what you're gonna do. You move on to your next chapter today, but I want to encourage you not to leave us behind. Once a part of the Colin Powell School family, you're always a part of the Colin Powell School family. And so, you know, as you go out and find jobs, as you grow your family, as you face opportunities, and as you face challenges, stay in touch with us, because we want to be a part of supporting everything you're doing to make this city, this community, and this nation a better place. And in the future, when you're asked, where'd you go to college, I hope you will proudly say, the Colin Powell School for Civic and Global Leadership at the City College of New York. This place belongs to you. And this place is proud of you and excited for you today, all of us. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Good morning and welcome. My name is Linda Powell, and I am a very proud member of the Colin Powell School Board of Visitors. And I have had that affiliation, fancy sounding affiliation, for almost a decade. But I feel like I have been a member of the City College family all of my life. I grew up listening to my father, class of 1958, talk about City College, talk about the transformative effect that City College had on his life. It's my trust, it's my hope, it's my belief that it's been the same for you, because City College is such an amazing and special place. I wish I could be there with you in person. I wish I could be on the lawn and feel your joy, feel your family's pride, but I'm glad I have this opportunity. I'm glad I have this opportunity to personally say congratulations to the class of 2020. You students are the bedrock of City College, and Colin Powell students are what make Colin Powell School. Congratulations. And now it is my very distinct pleasure to introduce my dad, General Colin Powell, Chairman of the Colin Powell School Board of Visitors. Dad.
Thank you, Linda, and good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I cannot tell you what a great pleasure it is for me to be here this afternoon with you to celebrate another graduating class from the Colin Powell School. And it's pretty cool to have a school named after you. And I couldn't be prouder of anything more. I remember when I first came to this wonderful institution some 62 years ago, I didn't know where I would be going, where I would be heading. But there were people here who were willing to give me a chance, who were willing to make sure that I got an education. It was a close-run thing because I wasn't the greatest student they've ever seen, but ROTC pushed me in the right direction. So I'm one of the proudest City College graduates there has ever been, because I was able to move to the top of my profession of soldiering and also in the diplomatic world. But I'll never forget how it all started. When I left the State Department, I came back to City College to see what was going on in the center that had been named after me, a small center. And as I sat there with about 12 students, each one of them telling me their wonderful story, almost always an immigration or minority story, when they got back around to me, I was almost crying because that was me. That was me 50 years ago, a kid from an immigrant family, two wonderful, beautiful parents who really weren't high school graduates and certainly didn't attend college, who came to this country hoping for a better future, who got that better future. They never became rich, they never became famous, and they had two children. They wanted those two children to be educated. So education was the whole purpose of their being at that time. And my education was through the public school system of New York, PS 20, PS 39, Milton Junior High School, and then finally Morris High School, and then ultimately City College of New York. I'll never forget walking on campus that day, meeting Raymond the Bagel Man, and then fitting in, and knowing that this was going to be for me. It took me several years to finish my education here, but every day was precious, every year was precious. And I'll never forget all the love and consideration that the faculty had given me. The kind of love and consideration that all of you have received while you've been there. So I pay credit to you, the students who have done the work, finished it, and can be very proud of your accomplishments. I also want to thank and send my love to all the parents who pushed you through, who took care of you, who made sure that you got through. All your parents, all your caregivers. Make sure that you thank them when the session is over. I also want to thank the people of the City of New York for having in place such a great school system that allows people like me, like you, to get an almost free, in my case, it was a free education. Free education that said to me, okay, you're coming from poor immigrant parents, but now you're on your way somewhere. Make sure that you get there and make sure you never forget us. I will never forget CCNY. I will never forget either the Colin Powell School because it is my school. I'm so proud of what you have done. I'm so proud of your parents, I'm so proud of the teachers. I'm so proud of this very institution that allowed me to move up in the world. So God bless you all. Enjoy your day. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Cesar Conde. I'm chairman of the NBC Universal News Group, and I'm honored to be one of the newest members of the Colin Powell School Board of Visitors. I've had the privilege of knowing General Powell for almost 20 years, and he's always spoken with such pride about City College, and especially pride in all of you. I'm excited to be part of this organization, and I congratulate each and every one of you for graduating from the Colin Powell School of Civic and Global Leadership. I also want to thank President Boudreau and Dean Rich for their leadership during this unprecedented moment in history. Clearly, this was not where we thought we were going to be 2 months ago. All of us are living through history, and you are making history. Making history by being the first class ever to complete your studies and graduate during a global pandemic. Making history by being the first graduates to have a virtual commencement ceremony. And making history by many of you being the very first in your families to graduate from college. I was looking forward to joining you as commencement speaker this year and seeing you in caps and gowns on the beautiful and historic City College campus. I'm so honored that you allowed me to be part of this milestone in your lives. It's truly a special day, and I want to also congratulate all the parents, families, and friends who are watching today who are bursting with pride. Today represents a collective journey where many people have played a role to help you graduate succeed. So I'd like to say a few words to the parents and families. I know many of us are living through uncertain moments right now, but extraordinary times require extraordinary strength. From the bottom of my heart, I want to commend you all for your efforts, sacrifice, and unwavering support that you've given these graduates. Please know that your children are going into the world with the very best education possible. A los padres, madres y familias, yo sé que estos son momentos difíciles para muchos de ustedes. Estamos viviendo tiempos extraordinarios que requieren de una actitud extraordinaria. Desde el fondo de mi corazón, los felicito por su gran esfuerzo y trabajo. Y les aseguro que a pesar de la incertidumbre en que vivimos, sus hijos están graduando con la mejor educación que ustedes le pudieron haber dado para ser exitosos en este mundo. Ustedes nos inspiran y nos dan fuerza para seguir adelante día tras día. Felicidades. And to you, the graduates, as a son of immigrant parents who came to this country in search of the American dream, I know how much you appreciate the sacrifice your parents have made for you. Please make sure you look them in the eyes today and thank them and give them a big hug, socially distanced, of course. You're all graduating into a world that is changing faster than ever, but you are walking away from this school with the strength and skills that our country needs. Today, the world needs leaders that can work with people of diverse ideas, thoughts, and backgrounds, and who demonstrate empathy for other people's perspectives and culture. As graduates of the Colin Powell School, you have been immersed in a diverse, globalized environment that has given you the necessary foundation to adapt and thrive in this ever-changing society. We need leaders who are comfortable walking in different worlds. We need leaders like you. In closing, I'd like to share the simple but powerful values my parents instilled in me and I have carried my entire life. Dream big, work hard, and stay humble. Dream big because anything is possible in this country with a great education. Work hard because nothing worth achieving in life comes easily. And stay humble because none of us succeed in life without some help from others along the way. And being humble means reaching back to help people coming up behind us. I would have wished nothing more than to share this day with you and your families in person, and I regret that we can't all be together this year. However, I encourage you and your families to join us next year, in 2021, for another historic moment, a double Colin Powell School commencement, where I'm honored to have been asked to join as the commencement speaker. So I congratulate you on this incredible accomplishment today. Know that your future is as you define it. Embrace this moment. Thank you, and muchísimas gracias.
Hello, my name is Randall Conway. I've been selected to be the valedictorian for the Colin Powell School in 2020. No speech will do this occasion justice if it fails to address the current crisis. And yes, we are in a national crisis, for an unexpected enemy has reared its head and made havoc on society. It has swiftly caused us to alter the way we live our lives and maintain distance from one another as we shelter in our homes. Still, far too many names we once took for granted now only live in our hearts and our memories. It has also reminded us of the political cleavages that separate us by wealth, race, status, and religion. We see this in the wavering confidence in our public institutions, the malaise of those less well off, and most visibly, armed protests in state capitals. However, this is not the first shock that I and many of you have experienced. Some of you may remember 9/11, when another enemy, quite unlike the classic villains who threatened us in eras past, changed their lives. A middle schooler living in a quiet, safe Connecticut suburb, lacking basic understanding of what happened, I came of age watching the government erect vast bureaucracies for the sake of homeland security. Our military spent decades deployed in distant lands, tasked with rooting out the enemy, both real and perceived. Many, including myself, now consider these wars foreign policy blunders, and perhaps the worst that we've had in our history. I had a rather forgettable part in these wars. Tasked with escorting foreign workers during my time in Iraq, I had the fortune of access not only to Iraqis, but people from all over the Middle East. Though they still spoke of American virtues, such as freedom, and they seemed to like our place in the world as the most powerful nation. I sensed a well-deserved tenseness in these stories. After all, they lived through brutal wars and insurgencies. The level of suffering they felt was far more palpable and on a scale greater than ours. While we count thousands among our dead during these wars, they saw hundreds of thousands perish. Though still loving this country, I felt ashamed of its actions and wondered how and why this happened. Perhaps this was the beginning of my lifelong love of international relations. More recently, you all remember the financial crisis of 2008. The solvency of this nation was shaken, and our belief in the increasingly elusive American dream also went the same way. Gone are the expectations of increasing wages. I was actually lucky during this time. I had a very nice job in the Air Force, but eventually I did leave, and when I separated, I got a job making $10 an hour. Unfortunately, that wasn't even the lowest wage being offered at the place I worked. And such are the times that, you know, we seem to go forth in the world today. It seems the only stability we have is constant instability. The only expectation is of the unfolding crisis yet expected. Our only hope is the things that we seem to despair. One would expect that a grim reality lends itself to a grim outlook, but this is not the unfolding story I've observed. And I don't mean to proffer the old stale arguments that appeal to national pride as though we will overcome solely by our exceptional Americanness, that success is somehow our birthright. Rather, my confidence is in the fruits of our toils, our blood, sweat, and tears. I hope we shall learn the lessons of recent history and make the world what it can become. I've gained confidence by roaming the halls of City College. In fact, I've practically lived there these past few years. But one of my favorite memories is staying in the political science lounge some nights well past 12 o'clock and being kicked out. The security guards kind of know about this. My friend Harut and I were, you know, constant offenders. The friends I've made want to take up the challenges of these times. Rather than a career that will be just merely some type of economic advancement, the people I've met at City College seem to want to serve a purpose. They want to serve people. Some of my friends I've made want to be lawyers, rather than trying to find their way to the best law firm or the biggest law firm. They speak of serving regular people like immigrants and people that won't give you a lot of money. The people I've met here that want to be politicians don't dream of just becoming president or the next senator. Rather, they talk about, you know, serving at a rather lower level, serving the community, essentially. City College produces professionals. It's just not people who just want to make a lot of money. It seems to be people who have what I call the activist mindset. In fact, I think this is a virtue, and perhaps the best thing about the school is that people who graduate from it want to serve people. And this gives me a lot of confidence that the graduates of this year will go on and make the world a better place. Now I would like to thank some of the faculty that have helped me out over the years. The first person I think of is probably Professor Bernstein. He was the first person I even talked to when I first came to City College. He led me along the way the entire time there. The next person is probably Professor Krinsky, who challenged me quite a bit when I was writing my thesis. He forced me to really question many of the concepts that I was taking from other academics and really question them and make them better myself. And he turned my work into something that was truly my own. Next, I would like to thank Professor DeSalvo, who after taking one class with him has pretty much been my guardian angel. Many of the opportunities I was able to take advantage of when I was at City was because of him, and he's been there from ever since. And finally, Professor Menon, who, when I was applying to a PhD program at UChicago, really helped me put together my package. And I also had a lot of hours with him in office hours, and we spoke about a lot of different things. These people put their names behind me on a professional level, and I sincerely appreciate it. Finally, I would like to extend the congratulations to the graduates this year. You guys have put in a few years of hard work, a few years of getting in on a new semester, everything seems to be running smoothly, then all of a sudden a month in, you have five midterms. None of this was easy, and I'm glad to have come through this with many of you. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Amelia Smith. I'm one of your salutatorians from the class of 2020, triple majoring in Jewish Studies, International Studies, and Economics. And I wanted to share one of my favorite memories from my past 4 years at the Colin Powell School. It was the spring semester of my sophomore year, and I had just decided on a study abroad program for the following semester. But because it was a third-party program, I needed the final okay from the Colin Powell School. I remember walking in there that day so nervous that they would tell me no. But before I could even get into the details of specific classes that I would be taking, my advisors reassured me that no matter what it took, they would be there to make sure that it could happen. And I'm just so incredibly thankful for their support in that moment, but also their support over the past 4 years. So big thank you to them, and a congratulations to the rest of the graduating class.
Thank you. Hi everyone, I am Amanda Kellowin and I'm an economics major. One of my favorite memories on campus was the 2016 Holi celebration. I didn't know about the event beforehand, and my friends and I were walking past Shepherd and we saw a group of students having fun with these colorful powders. So we thought, why not? Let's be a part of it. And we joined and we had a fabulous time. And we all looked the same afterwards. No one was recognizable, but I guess that's part of the fun. But I think what was more interesting was that there were students there from different ethnicity, culture, religions, all having a happy time together. And yes, I knew coming in that City College was known for its diversity, but to actually see students accepting and indulging in each other's cultures respectfully was truly heartwarming.
Hello to the Colin Powell School for Civic and Global Leadership. This is Senator Chuck Schumer, and it's my honor to address the faculty and staff, families and friends of the graduates, but most of all, you, class of 2020. As we all know, these are truly difficult times, perhaps more difficult than most of us have ever experienced. Our society will overcome this pandemic, and so will you. And when the worst is over, we'll need your help to rebuild our country even stronger than it was before. You are our future leaders, and we have faith in you. So to the graduates, I say once again, congratulations. Good luck. Godspeed. Thank you.
I'm Senator Kirsten Gillibrand, and I'm delighted to send my best wishes to the Colin Powell School for Civic and Global Leadership's Class of 2020. Now more than ever, we need smart, driven, and principled young leaders like you as we look to solve unprecedented challenges and build a better world. I know we're in good hands with you. While I know many of you are separated from loved ones and friends today, please know that the love and pride they feel for you is stronger than any divide we face. Congratulations, graduates.
Hi everyone, my name is Sadia Baksh and I'm a graduating psychology major. I just wanted to share one of my most challenging but also cherished memories of my time at City College, and that is my research experience. I had the honor of conducting research with Dr. Sarah O'Neill related to adult onset ADHD in the Attention and Neuropsychological Development Lab. My research has taught me a lot about patients and a lot about finding the art in questioning what seems apparent. Before joining the psychology department, I definitely liked answers that were black and white, but the field has really taught me to be more of a critical thinker, and Dr. O'Neill has truly guided me to evolve into a more collaborative worker. I'll never forget how excited my peers and I would be about our end of semester lab parties to celebrate our work. It just goes to show that the struggles that we face as a class, like the countless hours spent on my research thesis, for example, it just makes our accomplishments all the more rewarding. I'm so beyond proud to be a Colin Powell graduate, and I'd like to extend my warmest congratulations to the class of 2020. All the best.
Thank you. Hello, graduates. I'm Stacey Abrams. Please accept my deepest congratulations to the 2020 class of the Colin Powell School for Civic and Global Leadership at City College of New York. As you have been trained, you are meeting the unexpected challenges that threaten our civil society, our health, and our economic futures. How we meet this moment will define this nation and set the course for recovery. You arrived here driven by a desire to serve and the obligation to know more about the world around you. Among the nearly 1,000 students graduating today, there are those who will tackle the issue of public health infrastructure and global health security. Your class will address the insecurity of climate change and the scourge of hunger and homelessness. You will cast your eyes abroad and seek answers to rising authoritarianism and how to deploy sustainable development to under-resourced nations. The school is sending out a diverse cohort of graduates into this new world from all walks of life, including first-generation college students and those who immigrated to the United States to pursue their academic and professional objectives. I challenge you all to pursue this purpose even more vigorously, because leadership is needed now more than ever. The next generation of dedicated public servants with a strong commitment to social and economic justice includes you. You will not be defined by the end of one semester or one academic program, but by the legacy you carry with you into the world. And we can't wait to see what's next. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Class of 2020, congratulations on your graduation. My name is Harris Khan. I was a graduate for the class of 2019. I was also the student body president, and the Colin Powell School literally has changed my life. It's where I found a lot of my friends, met all these people with shared interests that don't agree 100% on everything with me, but I can have a conversation with and feel like we're growing and learning. The professors that I met, the mentors that I had, and really the ability to graduate from college debt-free with a world-class education, that makes Colin Powell School stand out. I am so proud of all that you've done. It was hard enough graduating from college. I remember senior year freaking out and senioritis hitting hard. You guys have it worse because you guys are dealing with this pandemic and your families and your communities are hurting. But I know that if there's anybody ready to take on these challenges, especially the recovery that's going to be long, it's going to be painful as well, I think it'll be Colin Powell School grads, and I'm pretty sure it'll be all of you. So I look forward to all the amazing work that you guys are going to do, especially right now, especially in times like these, but also beyond. really, really proud. Beaver Nation, let's go.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
Congratulations, I hope you have a wonderful day and many greetings from Germany.
I wish you guys the best of luck and hope you guys have the brightest futures.
And congratulations once again.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. For generations, City College of New York has ensured that students of every background are able to have access to higher education and open the door for greater opportunity, and countless Americans have taken that door. Today, you join a long line of proud CCNY graduates who have made this country better and made the world stand up and look. Jonas Salk, General Colin Powell, Ira Gershwin, Secretary Henry Kissinger, Wendy Wasserstein, a score of Nobel laureates. But even though graduation may look a little different this year, the accomplishment is as important and meaningful as it ever has been, and I'm so proud of everything you've achieved. These are different and uncertain times for all of us. And for any of you who might have lost a loved one to this pandemic or have family members working in essential jobs, putting themselves at risk, know that I'm thinking about you. We're all thinking about you. But here's what else I know. We're going to get through this, and we're going to need your passion, your integrity, and the skills that all of you have to offer to help rebuild and transform this country into a better country than it was even before this. We have a genuine opportunity to come out of this crisis stronger than we've ever been. In this class of 2020, you're going to be a big part of that. I wish we could all be together today to celebrate the incredible milestone of your young lives, but I can't wait to see what all of you are going to accomplish. Congratulations. We're going to make the country better than it was before this crisis. It's going to be because of you.
My dear members of the class of 2020, allow me to offer my heartfelt congratulations on the occasion of your graduation from the City College. Every fall, we hold freshman convocation in the Great Hall, our most sacred educational space. And on that occasion, I ask incoming students to look around this room and to think of the grandeur of the architecture on this campus, and to remember and internalize the fact that in 1847, when CCNY was first established, that those founders established this college explicitly and precisely for people like our incoming students. They didn't know that we would come from all over the world. They didn't imagine that we would educate women. They had no idea that we would arrive at this moment where we are as diverse ethnically, religiously, racially as we are today. But they knew that the college was designed to establish the whole people. Today I have a different message for you. Today you have studied with us for 4 years or 5 years or 6 years. You have become part of that great tradition of City College. You have become part of CCNY. Today, what I want to say is back in 1847 and ever since, while people were excited about the prospect of extending opportunity to young men and women, they weren't primarily thinking about your individual benefit. They knew, as we know today, that our society would never be fully democratic, entirely just, as stable or prosperous as it could be without the energies and talents of the whole people. They knew that a society that declined to educate the whole people was wasting human talent, and a day would come when that talent was essential. You're graduating at an extraordinary moment. You're graduating at a time when cities all over the country, where nations around the world are grinding to a halt, when the opening of our society and our cultural institutions and our economy, the reestablishment of our city and our nation on more just foundations is going to require the talent of the whole people. And so I say not that City College was established for you, but this moment, this crisis, this is what we were made for. This is why the college was established. This is why you were admitted to the campus. This is why, as you leave here as graduates of CCNY, you leave here with a mission. And never has that mission been more critical. You have asked questions that probably don't get asked in other places. You've arrived at answers that maybe aren't developed in other conversations. You have developed a perspective on leadership and service and the need to provide medicine to the whole people and the idea of engineering for the whole people and science for the whole people and leadership of the whole people that is unique to this institution. And so as you graduate today with that charge and that burden and that opportunity, I say to you this: be cognizant of the legacy of this institution. Be proud of what you've learned here, and never forget that as a son or a daughter of City College, you are precious, you are unique, and we will be proud of you forever. Congratulations, graduates.
Congratulations,
class of 2020.
Congratulations.
Well done.
We are not-